Brian Browse is going to join me here just momentarily. We were broadcasting our girls' game, playing right behind us over here at home tonight as well, as they're playing the Community Braves, trying to split that series this season, which is looking pretty promising as we go into the top of the seventh. Excuse me, they're in the bottom of the sixth. 6-0 in favor of your Lady Farmers. Leading off tonight for the Cattle Mills Foxes is number 10, Wade Bowen. Wade Bowen's playing left field tonight for the Foxes. Sunshine's decided to peek out tonight. It's been overcast all day. Barry comes set. Here's the first pitch. Just misses outside for ball one. Fastball catches the outside corner, evens the ball. One ball, one strike. Little bloop to shallow right field, right behind second base, as Bowen's able to put the ball in play. Next up for the Foxes, number two, shortstop, Colby Porter. Little chilly evening tonight for the Farmers baseball. It's about 59 degrees at first pitch. Swinging a foul for Porter. We were a nice little warm upper 80s at first pitch Tuesday night. They say if you don't like the weather in Texas, just give it 5 minutes. JV won against the JV Foxes prior to this game, 5-2. JV's been playing some good baseball here lately. A little throw over to first by Barry. Keep Bowen honest. Respectable lead there at first by Bowen. Get him, Bay. You know, with the left-handed pitcher, you do have to be cautious there. Really pay attention to his motions, to his set sequence. I'm not sure when time was called, but I'm not a fan of that when a pitcher's in motion. Even if he does, go ahead and throw that ball home. That's a good way to get yourself injured on the mound. One ball, one strike on Porter. Quick pick to first by Gray. Oh, and he did. I stand corrected. I will take it. One ball, two strikes on Porter. Great throw by Brady Gray from his knees to get Bowen out at second. Two balls, two strikes. Clears the bases. Great defensive play by catcher Brady Gray. Logan Dale with a great tag puts that down. Sun shining right in his face. Doesn't make that an easy catch. Ball misses just outside. Fills up the count on Porter. Three balls, two strikes. One out, nobody on here in the top of the first. Skies that to right field. Caden Norman should camp underneath that for an easy can of corn for out number two.
Up next, third baseman, number 14, Talon McIntosh.
Next up for the Foxes, number 14, McIntosh, playing third tonight. Two outs here at the top of the first. Barry's just missing just a bit outside with his fastball. Kind of out of norm for him. See if he can get settled in here. Swing and a miss. Evens count, one ball, one strike. Just misses out of the top of the zone. Two balls, one strike. Just catches the zone there. We've got a foul ball come over from the girls. Barry's going to make a quick toss of that. Two balls, two strikes on McIntosh with two outs here, nobody on. Colin gets a sign. Line drive to left field is going to stay in fair. Good barrel by McIntosh there. Going to stay there at second with a stand-up double.
Up next, the pitcher, number one, Bobby Barrow.
Next up for the Foxes, number one, Barrow. He's going to be your starting pitcher tonight for the Foxes. After that line drive to left, we've got two outs, runner at second here in the top of the first. Checking the runner. He's going to leave it a ball. I thought it'd snake through the zone there. This is low and inside on Barrow. Two balls, no strikes. Pokes that outside pitch just into the first base bullpen. Two balls, one strike. Quick throw to second. Just able to get back there. Logandale makes a quick tag on the diving McIntosh. Two balls, one strike on Barrow. As Colin delivers. Looks like that's going to get foul on the right side. Evens account, two balls, two strikes. Brady's going to take a quick trip to the mound. Settle him down a little bit. Sunglasses are out on all of our infielders. Mine is Strawn over there. He's camped out in the shade. Been overcast all day, no sunshine, and then come first pitch, it decides to poke out. It's going to be off his foot. It's not what you want to see as your starting pitcher takes one off the toe. And I take it that's going to be his plant foot. Assuming he's a right-handed pitcher. Two balls, two strikes. McIntosh at second with two outs here in the top of the first. Barry gets a sign to come set. Little poke to second. Graves able to snag that out of the air for out number three. After the top half, one runner stranded at second. No score for the Foxes. We'll be back in just a moment.
There's
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, here to the bottom of the first inning between this matchup of the Farmers and Foxes. After top half of the inning, one runner was stranded, no runs were scored. Leading off for your Farmers is going to be catcher Brady Gray.
Number 30, Brady Gray.
Brady hitting right at 300 this season. Actually leads the Farmers with runs scored. Getting on base has been a priority for Gray. Top of the lineup last game, struggled a little bit. The bottom half was able to pick them up. We would have closed that win out. Fouled straight back for ball one. Yes, our Lady Farmers just happened to win their game against Community with a shutout 6-0. As Gray fouls that straight back to the screen, they were able to split that series with the Lady Braves. We lost a couple weeks ago 3-2, which we haven't lost against the Braves in a few years now. Sorry about that. Missed a ball there as I was looking over my shoulder. So that was the full count pitch. Leadoff walk for Brady. Next up for the Farmers, number 10, first baseman Cooper Strong. Cooper's been hot all year on the mound and at the plate. A respectable 425 on the season. Quick throw over to first. Keeping Gray honest. Foxes know that we do want to make a quick jump and take any advantage of a runner that we have. Swing and a miss and a pass ball. Going to be a strike on Strong, but not before it's able to move Gray up to second base. Takes away the double play here for the Foxes. Runner in scoring position at second base for the Farmers. Strong's looking for something to put in the left center. Showed bunt. Umpire showing two balls. Cooper did swing and miss at the first pitch. We'll see what he does after this pitch. Line drive and a double out.
Up next, the pitcher, number 5, out of the
able to double up Gray. Just, he did freeze somewhat on the line drive, just not able to get back with the secondary lead that he had there. Two outs here in the bottom of the first, brings up number 5. Colin Berry pitching tonight for the Farmers. Did he call that a strike? Yeah. Fouled straight back here. Berry falls behind quick 0-2. Just a bit outside. That's my best Bob Uecker impersonation. Barry pops that one to second base as he scoots back for out number three. Three up, three down for the Farmers here in the bottom of the first. After one, Fox is zero and the Farmers zero. We'll be back in just a moment for the top of the second.
Let's give them a big hand. Way to go, Lady Farmers.
You haven't climbed up to Enchanted Rock, drinking cold shiner down and looking back, taking your baby to the river walk. You ain't met my Texas kids. If you haven't floated down the Ofrio, heard red dirt music on your radio, Eden Cooper's down in Leno.
Drive down in Porty, heard the words of Christie Bay. Never seen fireworks on PK. You ain't got my Texas yet. Haven't had a Karachi when you go through West. Never heard of a Mary Jo Taylor Fest. Ain't polished pop country.
Up first from Foxes, center fielder, number three, Luke Douglas.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, here in the top of the second. Leading off for the Foxes, number three, Luke Douglas. Barry comes set. Here's the first pitch. Swing straight back to the backstop. Strike number one. Swing and a miss on Douglas. Gets behind 0-2. Fouls that one back over the screen.
Hello.
Yeah, Mr. Brazel able to finish up calling the win over there. 6-0.
Jamie Varga with the complete game shutout. Did an awesome job.
Great job.
Not sure what I missed over here. Didn't look like a whole lot of action yet.
No, it was three up, three down, and three up, three down.
I can keep up with those stats.
Got caught in a line drive double play at second. Line drive for Mason Irwin. Makes it look easy for out number one here in the top of the second. Next up, catcher number five, Robinson for the Foxes.
Our third counterpart, Mr. Jaron McTee, just headbutted Mr. G there.
He probably wants those alien ears that he's got. We had a teacher appreciation tonight over there at the Lady Farmers softball complex. And Jamie Varga had requested that Mr. G come out there on her behalf. And told him that, I guess they gave him a gift tonight and told him that he had to wear the alien ears or dragon ears, whatever they were, for the remainder of the two games.
Makes him look a little bit like Shrek.
I thought it made him look a little bit better. David Coleman up here with the jokes. If you guys only knew. One ball, two strikes. That one misses just in the dirt. Evens the count, two balls, two strikes on Robinson. Chopper to second. Graves fields it cleanly. Big throw to Strawn with the out at first.
Up next.
Quick two outs for the Farmers.
Hitter number 22, Cesar Cantu.
Good job. DH for the Fox tonight, number 22, Cantu.
Didn't see the first inning, but Calden looks like he's in control up there right now. First couple of batters that I have seen.
Yeah, it took him a little bit to get settled down. He threw 24 in the first. Just
nice curveball there. Ooh, a little high.
Just misses. His fastball just wasn't quite catching the outside corner.
Gotcha.
Just missed a little bit.
Looks like settled in here, though, in the second inning.
Yeah, quick two outs after seven pitches. Two balls, one strike.
No.
I do believe it is, Jared. Fouls that one straight back. Evens account. Two balls, two strike. Strikes, plural. With two outs here in the top of the second. A lot of twos. Barry comes set. Gray setting up just outside.
Mm. Nice little drag back right there by Brady Gray. Brings that one back across the black as
much
Barry gets
blue.
That. Yeah, gets that outside pitch for a called strike three. So
we'll be back in just a moment with your Farmers hitting in the bottom of the second. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, here in the bottom of the second, leading off for the Farmers. Number 14, Mason Irwin. Yes, Brian, in regards to the district, 2-4 for the Farmers, for the Foxes, and 6-0 for your Farmers. First pitch swing in there for Irwin as he fouls that one back over to the first base dugout. Barrow. Is their second guy. He's on the bump tonight. That baby blue, Carolina blue glove.
Yeah, easy to see that.
Same breaking pitch.
Same result.
Yeah, same spot. Ball misses just outside and high. One ball, two strikes.
So your Farmers are undefeated in district?
Yes, sir. 18-3 on the season.
Got a nice little roll going.
Yes, sir.
Fights off that outside breaking ball.
Sun's finally down. It decided to poke out right at first pitch.
Yeah, it did.
Great job by Irwin to hold off on that, especially when he swung at that breaking pitch. It's a little outside. Evens account, two balls, two strikes. Fouls that one back here to the net.
Seems like that wind's died down a little bit out there as that sun's gone down.
Yeah, flags are just barely blowing over here to our left.
A lot stronger earlier in the day. Shouldn't have much of effect here. And ball. Jaren agrees, and that's all that matters.
That's it. He has spoken. That ball in dirt brings a count full on Irwin.
See if we can't get a runner on here. Some speed.
Swing and a miss. Okay. First out of the inning. Logan Dale. Next up for the Farmers, number one, shortstop Logan Dale. Logan Dale's done a great job this year of getting on any way he can.
Had a couple of really long at-bats that last game we called on Tuesday.
Yeah, and with the walk, and then he gets a two-base error.
Yep.
You know, like I said, any way that he can get himself on the base.
Create a little chaos there on the base paths.
You know, a lot of people want to look at batting average, quote-unquote.
On base.
I like seeing that on-base percentage. Yeah.
Yep.
Because with his speed and baseball knowledge, you know, getting him out there, he's an asset when we've got guys, you know, coming back behind him that can hit and drive him in. That ball gets away from the catcher all the way to the backstop. Two balls, no strikes on Dale.
Swing and a miss on an outside pitch there. Makes it two balls and a strike. Good eye there on 2-1 pitch. Wonder what it cost me to have Coach Norton come take care of my yard. Field looks great.
Yeah, he was up here. I agree.
And there is a walk.
Same thing I was just talking about. You know, being disciplined up there, that ball just missed out of the strike zone. But, you know, going back to somebody of Cooper Strawn's size versus his size, completely different strike zone.
Completely agree.
Letters and knees is different on those two gentlemen. Next up, number 22, KJ, third baseman for the Farmers. One out, Logan Dale on first after that walk. First pitch low in the dirt. I know what I was saying. It was the other day, Saturday, Sunday. Coach Norm was up here scraping the lines, getting the overgrowth out, keeping those baselines sharp.
Well, it looks really good. Does a great job for sure. Popped up to the right side. Pitcher go ahead and calls off the first baseman, which you and I just talked about in the softball games. Not common. Brings up Malone here with two outs in the bottom of the second inning. Still a scoreless tie.
We were talking, or I was mentioning earlier, 7-8-9 singled and drove in runs last game when we played community here to get that 3-0 shutout. Logan should advance safely on that, and he does.
Gets under the throw there. Aggressive base running the ball. It didn't get too far away from the catcher.
Still a good throw if you look at it.
Shoot, yeah. You got a runner in scoring position now.
Porter tried to slap a tag on him. One ball, no strikes on Malone. Little soft dribbler to third. McIntosh with the throw is wide. Logan is able to score standing up. They are going to squeeze and hold up Malone at second.
Malone gets down the base path well. And third baseman looked up and saw Malone about halfway down there, rushed the throw, not able to set his feet. And the poor throw ends up with the runner scoring and another one going to second. So
kind of looks like the start from the other evening.
Really does, yep.
Well, that error put Malone at second base brings up number 7, Paxton Graves, second base for the Farmers.
Graves takes one on the outside corner there, called strike. Hits the second pitch to center field. Center fielder camps under it, makes the play. That'll be the end of the inning, but not before the Farmers are able to put one on the board. Take a 1-0 lead as we move into the top of the third. We'll be right back.
Struggle, sacrifice.
Caddo. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We have a special guest tonight, actually two. Starting pitcher for the Lady Farmers, J.B. Varga and Carly Deeds are going to join us for a quick inning. Ladies, welcome. Pretty good little...
nice win tonight.
Revenge game tonight.
Very revenge, yes.
Because it was a 3-2 loss there a few weeks ago.
Yep.
And it had been a while since we lost against Community.
Oh, yeah.
So I think the intensity was different tonight.
Oh, it was a complete kill mentality. It was just, we were going out there to show them who was boss, basically.
Good.
Sure. Yeah.
Well, and congrats on a good game on the mound.
Thank you.
Yeah, nice little complete game shutout. Jaren agrees. There's not much that he doesn't agree with, though, we've learned.
Unless I'm talking.
It's true. Yeah. So what's next for you ladies?
We have Caddo Mills. Is that correct? Yeah, Caddo.
Caddo coming up next?
Correct.
Tuesday at Caddo at 5:30.
We're going to be Tuesday at Caddo at 7:15.
So are there two games left in district for y'all?
Yes, we have Caddo and Sunnyvale.
Okay. And then the playoffs.
Yes. Favorite time of the year.
That's right. And you guys have already qualified, right?
Yes. Okay. We are now going to flip with Community to see who gets first seed and second seed.
Ugh.
So...
the dreaded flip.
Yeah.
We know all too well about that. So talking about flips, you know, we put the spanking on Community last Friday night, which was good at their place. That's where we lost the coin flip last year.
Yeah.
We came over here and secured the sweep against them Tuesday night. Like I said, the boys were playing with a different intensity. You girls were playing with a different intensity tonight. We saw that. I was able to broadcast the first five innings with Brian, and he was able to finish up so we could get this started.
Yeah, Jamie, I got a question for you. Him bringing up that intensity. So what was the difference in tonight's game versus the first game against Community? Did you guys come out with a different thought process? Did you have different preparation? What was the difference?
We definitely had a different preparation. I feel like we came out the first game just a little flat, and we thought that we had it, but they just came and snuck up behind us and got it. And then today we just – weren't letting loose. We were going for anything to show them that we just had a bad game and that they can't basically settle on us. So.
Yeah, y'all stay. And we talked about that too. Like, it seemed like you guys were aggressive at the plate. You were definitely aggressive on the mound, and you just carried that all the way through the game.
Yes, it was a different. It was a different mindset too. I feel like we just wanted it more than we did the first game. So.
Well, and you talk about. I think it was. Morgan Irwin's mom, we were playing in Ferris, so she was watching the live stream. Were y'all playing here?
Which game?
For that game, the one that you lost?
No, we went to Community.
She was keeping up with, it was Game Changer she was keeping up with. And the look in her face, because Morgan, I don't think in her high school, has lost to Community. So when you kind of get into that, like you said, mindset of, yeah, we're going to go over here and beat them, we're going to go to the playoffs. You do get maybe complacent is the nice word. That's a quick three up, three down, three strikeouts.
Struck out the side, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. You kind of get complacent, and you and I both know baseball, softball. I mean, you can come over here and lose 3-2, and then you can turn right around and play them and win 6-0.
Yep.
So we saw that from you girls. It's fun to watch you guys. Y'all's games are more, as I was telling Brian, they're more fast-paced. You guys have the dances. You guys got the jigs. You've got the celebrations. I think it's the fourth inning.
Yes, fourth inning party.
Yeah, the fourth inning party. But we'll switch over here to Carly Deeds here at the bottom of the third as the Farmers get the bat. I've got a little fan waving at me here
do.
At the bottom.
Can't wait till he's able to talk.
Yeah, it's a little chilly today. He's usually in his pinstripes and purple. I think we're switching headsets now. Now we've got a little height difference back from Carly to Jamie. So, Carly, give you credit real quick on that outfield assist from Cassidus when it went under her glove and they were going to send her home.
Yes.
That was a great little play out there. You know, that's just
– turn and throw.
Man,
communication
teamwork,
on the field.
The
yeah.
communication, we talked about that.
Yeah, I heard all the girls screaming 4-4-4, so I went for it. I was.
And that's great because, like I said, we had our windows closed because the wind was blowing in on us. It was a little chilly.
So, Carly, same thing for you. I guess same question that we talked to Jamie about is, like, how did you prepare differently for this game than that last one against Community?
For me, I was very not really thinking much about it the first time, but coming to this game, I know I had to have a stronger mindset and a better approach at the plate, just staying more focused.
Did Castillo throw the first game too as well?
Yes, she did.
Gotcha. So the second time that you see somebody like that, it's a little easier to kind of prepare for them and know what to expect, right?
Sorry, what?
No, I'm saying the second time that you see a pitcher like that, you kind of know what to expect a little bit more.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah, we've been working all week on her pitching.
How is practice? That's what I was going to ask. How was practices this week?
You know, it was kind of hard for me because the pitcher for community, she throws a lot of low outside, and that's what I've been struggling with. But I've been working really hard all week to really get my hands through the ball and push it.
Well, it definitely showed tonight. Like I said, you girls were able to shut it down 6-0. Norman able to poke that one just
right over the third baseman, yep.
For the leadoff single here in the bottom of the third. You know, we talk about, you've got practice, but you guys as athletes, I know both of you guys have already committed. There's stuff, there's so much more that you can do outside of practice that your coach is really not there to give you one-on-one. That is for you. And, you know, I've seen you girls up here. You know, you guys do the camps. We gave you guys credit over that. My little girl loves coming up there. She waves every time she sees you. And that's a big thing that not only are you guys top athletes, you know, you're top students, you're top members of our community. And I know that a lot of those little girls look up to you.
Yes, sir.
Brady gets that one. Drops that in between. Yeah, nice.
Great job.
Two little bloop singles in a row.
We'll take them.
Yeah, no, I agree with Nelson. Carly, you guys are really good role models for our young girls in the community. I've got two of them, and we really appreciate what y'all do, and we are y'all's biggest fans. Can't wait for playoffs to start for y'all.
Yes, sir. So excited. We love working with the girls. It's so fun to, like, see their little faces light up when we see them at our games. It just really gives us another boost.
And that's a whole other level of the game. You know, I see the energy that you guys have on the field, and then I also see you guys kind of docile that down in order to coach and communicate with those young girls, obviously with athletic ability being different, but the way you guys were able to get on their level and do that is it's a special thing. Like I said, these girls love it, they feed off of it, and I know that you guys have made some special trips to see the Little League.
Yes.
Cooper Strom,
another single there. Gonna load up the bases here with no outs.
With no outs, nothing else. We have to keep you guys up here.
Actually, Jamie, your mom told me that you were going to be a sports broadcaster in college. Is that right?
Yes.
How about I give you these headphones? You can call the rest of this inning with Nelson. Here
you go. You're going to boot me out of a job. Next up for the Farmers here in the bottom of the third, with bases loaded, no outs, number 5, pitcher Colin Berry. We're going to have Jamie Vargas sit here in Brian's spot. As you just heard, Brian had mentioned her mom said she wanted a career in broadcasting. So what better way to come out here and break the ice? Ball misses low for ball one.
I agree.
You agreeing with me or with her? Nobody's agreeing with you, Coleman.
No.
Ball 2 misses just low and outside there on Barry. Not very often we get to see a situation where we're bases loaded, one of our top hitters, and no outs. Situation 3-0. What are you doing there?
Probably just looking for the next pitch, just taking it super hard like I would swing, but just not swinging. Yeah.
There's a couple guys that one just snaked in there.
Mm-hmm.
There's a couple guys that Coach Norden will give the green light in a situation. But normally they're sitting on that. They're going to camp. That guy's thrown, you know, a few balls in a row. Same pitch. Looks like he snaked it right in there. Brings count full on Barry. Now, Jamie, you're a junior, correct?
I am.
Carly, the same
yes.
as you? Okay. Able to poke it. Should be a play at the plate with a force. Still have the bases loaded, one out. Next up for the Farmers is Mason Irwin, center fielder. Mason had a great game last week. Great defensively. Excuse me, earlier this week. In that game against community. Bases loaded here, one out. As Barrow delivers his first pitch, Irwin fouls that one straight back to the net. That ball low and outside evens the count, one ball and one strike. Swing and a miss for Mason.
Deeds, I have a question about that ball that you caught in the foul territory today.
Oh, great effort.
Very good effort. Were you, like, expecting it to come back in or out? Like, what were you seeing when it was in the air?
Honestly, I just saw it up, and I just started running towards the ball. My mindset was just, I'm going to catch this ball no matter where it's at, you know, full effort.
It's the same thing, Deeds, that you had when you, Jamie, y'all were both going for that ball straight up to the pitcher.
Oh, yeah.
Is that going to drop? Or you?
I feel like you would have had that if he would have went. It looked a little offside.
But, yeah, when you get locked in on a pitch, or excuse me, when you get locked in on a ball, especially on a catchable ball, you know, it's almost a mindset to, like, I'm going to catch this. Y'all better get out of my way.
Yes.
I'm calling it, you know. And regardless of who catches it, it just needs to be caught. But I saw yours you tracked over into foul territory behind first base, and then the one that you came in and tracked the pitcher there. So.
Yeah, I almost took Jamie out.
Yeah, we definitely had a little miscommunication because I was yelling her name. I was like, Deeds, Deeds, Deeds. And then I didn't see her coming. I was like, crap. I was like, this is about to drop. And the next thing you know, Speedy Gonzalez just comes and swipes me out of the way.
Break a pitch in there for strike two on Dale. Still have bases loaded. Irwin flied out to left field.
We definitely have a lot of speed on the bases, so if he could just put one through, it'd be good.
Yeah, base hit somewhere for sure. I'd like to see him work that gap right over second base, hitting behind these two lead runners. He hit it to second base, just not over him. Well, after three complete, your Farmers are leading 1-0 against the Foxes. We'll be back in just a moment. Ladies, thank you guys for joining us.
Thank you for having us.
Congrats on the win tonight.
Thank you.
This is true.
Asking me to sing like that. They'll get Farmersville school police, SROs up here.
Get yanked off the air.
Yeah. Well, here we are back at the top of the fourth. Your Farmers leading the Foxes 1-0. Leading off here in the top of the fourth, Kobe Porter.
Collins' first pitch on the way, a little low. Struck out the last three batters that he's seen.
Yeah, great little Top of the third there.
Yep. Had the softball girls in here. We didn't get a chance to talk a whole lot about actually what he was doing on the mound. He was moving the ball around really well.
Two balls, no strikes on Porter. Skies that one to Norman in right field. He's looking for it. Can't see it.
Yeah. As soon as it left the bat, he threw his hands up like he did not see where it was.
Not sure if he just didn't see it or lost it in a, you know, happened to look directly at a light.
Yeah, he never saw it. He just threw his hands up as soon as there was contact made. Sounds like my truck alarm back there behind us.
Is that your Civic?
I'm in the Prius today, sir.
There you go.
Yeah.
Swing and a miss by McIntosh.
Did it go off?
It
did. That actually was my truck. That's not a good sign that it was going off in the first place. Unless Jaron kicked my keychain in my pocket. He's been kicking me a lot over here.
Little pause real quick by Bray. You're going to go out there and talk to Cooper. Settle him down.
Or Colin.
That is correct.
Runner on second here. No outs. Top of the fourth. Your Farmers holding on to a 1-0 lead.
Good try.
Nice pitch.
Great pitch. Just in there for breaks in there to bring the count 0-2 on McIntosh.
Nice pitch.
Does a really good job of bringing that curveball back in that back door like that. Yeah. Yeah, I almost said something before he threw it. He never came to a stop whenever he was rolling through the stretch there.
Very rare for him.
Yeah, I almost said something, but he did kind of roll through. And he never actually came to a complete stop. So it's too bad. It was a good pitch, too.
Yeah, it was.
Yep, there you go. Came right back and threw another strike. So good job of kind of biting down and,
sure,
and fighting through that.
You know, you think about that and you moved a guy one base up closer to home. Obviously not what he wants to do as a pitcher. But able to sit back in there and get that strike.
Yep. And Jaron agrees, so we know we made a good point.
No.
First pitch outside.
This is the pitcher Barrow. Ahead 1-0.
A little high there.
Yeah, just misses upstairs.
Still trying to pick on that corner, though, which don't blame him. Getting some good calls out there.
Got the infield in on the grass.
I agree.
Farrell able to get out of the way of that low pitch in the dirt to avoid being hit by the pitch.
So 3-0 here. A walk's not the worst thing in the world. It does set up the ground ball, double play. And we saw a couple of those on Tuesday. So we know this Farmer infield is more than capable of putting those together. And that's what's going to happen here. So
it's a rare four-pitch walk for Barry. Like you said, runners on the corners. We still have the double play ball.
Yeah. That middle infield is going to deepen up now. Yeah. Go back to double play depth. Really, it's going to come down to, you know, looks like Barrow has probably got a little speed. So if they send him, what does Coach Norton decide to do? Play for the out? Maybe run the, the cutoff play if the runner goes.
Yeah.
It's where the
– there's just a lot of options you could do, you know.
Baseball.
We only have a one-run lead.
Yep.
And Brady still goes quite out a bit of baseball left.
Yeah, Brady went out. You saw him go out to the top of the circle there and signal to the infielders. Everybody's on the same page here. It goes right over the shortstop's head.
Nothing you can do about that.
No. Just one of those little CNI singles that is perfectly placed.
No.
With that bloop line drive over shortstop, able to score Porter for the Foxes. It evens a game 1-1. Runners on first and second with one out. You still have double play ball here in effect.
You do, but this, let's go back to that balk. And we, you and I have talked about it a lot of times about free bases.
Mm-hmm.
And that that free base right there really came back to kind of bite you, because not to say he couldn't have scored on that, but probably doesn't. And
correct, yeah.
Brady takes a foul off of the inner part of the leg or the hand. I couldn't tell there.
It might be that left arm.
Yeah, I got a little dead arm right now, it looks like. Looks like he's showing his thumb or his wrist.
Yeah, right there on his wrist. It looks probably good. Like you said, dead arm's a good just shot that straight down.
Yeah. So he's going to take as much time as he can. Yeah. Norton's going to give him some time to use one of his mound visits here to give Brady some time. Yeah, and he just pointed at letting him know it's an injury visit, not necessarily a mound visit. Hope Brady's all right. It'd be a loss back there for sure.
Let's go.
Oh, we kind of frogged him really good.
B-Dog.
Let's go, B-Dog, says Jaron.
Let's go, B-Dog. I bet he goes. He's a tough kid. Yeah, he's shaking.
Yeah, this kind of a district game.
Yeah.
You're going to have blood or bone showing.
Right, yeah.
For that kid to get out of here.
Yeah. Home game like this. Yeah. Still one out here in the top of the fourth.
Good job.
The Fox is able to scratch one across to tie it up 1-1.
Robinson showing bunt as he's in the box to bat for the Foxes. Got him.
Got him. Oh.
Ooh.
Sandy got under the tag. Yeah, that's a good move right there. That was a really good move. Cooper was able to tag him as he's going down as he catches the ball.
I was trying to help him.
Yeah.
No. Uh-oh.
Bounces in. Good job there, Brady, of blocking that one with the.
Yeah, right after that injury that he just had on. Yeah. You know, he's shoving that glove in the ground.
After a beat up wrist like that, yeah.
That pitch in the dirt evens the count, 1-1 on Robinson. Still showing bunt, pulling back.
Oh, wow.
Going to chop that.
They get the leader. Oh, it looks like he dropped it.
Graves dropped it at second.
Couldn't tell that was on the exchange, though. They're going to say it was a drop, but I would be questioning whether that was on the exchange or not.
Brings the bases loaded for the Foxes here with one out. At the top of the fourth, number 22.
Cantu.
Yeah, Cantu, the DH.
Yep. Infield's going to stay back at double play depth here.
Yeah, in on the corners.
Good job.
Nice little attempt there by Brady. Really keeps those guys honest. Don't see a lot of that.
You don't.
In high school baseball at this level.
And the runners don't see a lot of that.
That's
so they
what I'm
don't
saying.
Expect
yeah.
a quick back pick.
Good job. Brady keeps that in front of him as it bounces in. Colin rips the hat off, getting a little frustrated out there. If you see a ball here, my guess is it's probably somebody's going to go talk to him a little bit. Yep. Another back pick. So 3-0 here with the bases loaded.
You know, as a batter with bases loaded and Barry, obviously the pitcher, kind of struggling a little bit, it's a no doubt 100% red light right here.
Sure.
You know, because.
And it's a tough red light.
It is a tough red light.
He is. Young.
There you go. So Collins in the danger zone. I didn't want to say it before that pitch there, but kind of that danger zone where as a pitcher and you're frustrated and you're mad and you know you're better than that, you don't want to overthrow, and it's easy
sure.
to do. There's a good pitch.
Way to come back.
Yeah. Two called strikes in a row. Those are two really important pitches right there. So, yeah, he's done a good job of staying within himself. You can tell he's not overthrowing. That's what I was afraid he was going to do. There's the ground ball we needed.
Great twist and turn.
Got it.
What we've seen a couple times this year already.
Hey, what did we say in that last game?
I'm
a double play
you,
is a pitcher's best friend.
I wish it was one batter sooner, but we'll take it. So
absolutely.
After 3.5. Caddo was able to get a run, even the score 1-1. We will be back in just a moment as your Farmers come up to bat.
Hot coffee, hot cocoa, hot chili, hot dog. Come get you some concessions and feel the heat. We've got full concessions available for both Foxes and Farmers.
And we are back here in the bottom of the fourth as number 22, third baseman Caden Johnson is going to lead off for the Farmers. 6-7-8 here in the bottom of the fourth, batting for your Farmers. First pitch misses just outside for ball one. Upstairs, two balls, no strikes on Johnson. This game's actually going by pretty quick, Brian. We've been playing now for right at an hour, and we're
halfway through.
Yeah. Pitch catches bottom of the zone for strike one. Two balls, one strike on Johnson. Back up the middle of the slow roller. Porter makes the throw.
Nice play.
For out number one. Next up for the Farmers, number four, left fielder, Braden Malone.
Oh, shoot. I sent that to you instead of her. We're trying to multitask up here, not doing a very good job of it.
First breaking pitch in there for a strike on Malone.
Need a couple base runners this inning.
Big swing and a miss. Malone's behind 0-2 quickly.
Like the aggressiveness, though.
Yeah. In the dirt for ball one, brings the count one ball, two strikes on Malone.
It's a tough pitch to lay off to on 0-2.
Sure.
That breaking ball starts right down the middle and then breaks out. Ball's a little high. No, he didn't go.
He did not.
It's close, but he didn't. Two balls, two strikes.
I agree.
Sharply hit foul over the first base dugout.
There we go.
Able to work that count back full on Malone.
Really good job of making him throw some extra pitches up there.
I agree.
Full count pitch is low. Nice at bat by Malone right there. Fight back from 0-2 and get the walk. Just talked about getting some base runners on. You get one on that's got good speed. Graves behind him has been putting the bat on the ball. Let's see if Norton decides to do something here with one out. Sends a sign in.
agree.
Let's go, Jaron says.
Fouls that one back here to the screen for strike one.
Good try.
Runner on first, one out. Here in the bottom of the fourth, Graves has got a strike on that first foul.
Malone, the runner at first. Got a decent lead. Breaking ball catches the inside part of the.
That's a good pitch.
Yeah, that was a good pitch. It was, boy.
That started at his hip and broke right into that inside corner.
And that's as inside as you can go and get a strike call.
Two strikes here on Graves.
Malone.
Good block by Robinson back there. Able
Malone,
to keep that in front.
He thought about it, but I want to make that out there at second base.
Let's go, baby. You got this.
One ball, two strikes on Graves. As Malone takes his lead at first.
Get down, ball. Get down, ball. Yes. Nope, that was a trap. That was a trap. That was a trap. Yeah.
Graves able to put it in play, keep us alive here. One out, runners on the corners, brings up number four.
Come on, y'all. I mean, I can understand go out there and argue for it, but that was a trap, clear as day.
Nathan Norman.
Caddo coach is going to take a brief moment, talk to the infield umpire.
Yeah, it bounced. It bounced.
Now he's going to ask for the umpire's clarification from 200 feet away.
Yep, safe.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's the right call.
Just had to respect the coach.
Sure.
You know.
His request.
His request, correct.
But it's the right call. Good job.
Well, after that brief timeout, we've got runners on the corners after Graves' bloop single to right. One out. Here in the bottom of the fourth, Caden Norman due up for the Farmers.
See, I'm looking at those corner infielders. That third baseman's in a little closer than I'd like. If he was back a little bit, you could definitely think about putting one down here. But
sure.
Norman being left-handed and being as quick as he is. But
yeah, if he was playing behind the line, behind the bag, I would consider it. And Norman can shoot that down there.
Exactly.
But you've got to make sure on something like that that you get it.
It's got to be pushed.
You want to get past that pitcher's mound, you know, and it's almost got to be shot.
He was thinking it. Yeah, that's what I.
He did. Look at you thinking like a coach.
That's right.
Or a ball player who's been in that position. I mean.
Well, and that's why I love baseball. There's so much strategy. Every pitch, literally, there's some sort of strategy involved.
I'd like to see Graves get another step over there.
Third baseman's in on the grass now. I doubt you'll see the same attempt here.
Norman with a quick time.
But it did draw him in where, you know, something hit hard that way.
He's not going to be able to react to it quick enough. So, yeah. Yeah, the runner on third, like I said, I'd like to see Graves get another step. Norton may try to get him over. Throws his hands at that one. Evens the count, one ball, one strike.
Yeah, wouldn't be surprised to see Graves going.
And Robinson's got a good arm. You know, you've got a good shortstop combo out there. So if he is, he's going to have to.
Well, it's one of those where Graves goes, Malone can bluff to try to cut that throw off.
Ooh, he got that call.
He dragged that one back across.
Did.
A little Brady Grace special there. Yeah,
must have been watching Brady.
Yeah. Got a couple of those calls. One ball, two strikes here.
Norman's got to protect here.
Yeah, it takes the bunt out for sure. Ah, that outside corner.
Now back to the top of the order, number 30, Brady Gray.
Two outs here in the bottom of the fourth. Going to bring top of the order back up with runners on the corners, Brady Gray.
We were talking about this earlier in that at-bat to Colin Berry. And the pitcher, I can't remember his name. I think it's Barrow. But he really focused on that outside corner. He did the same thing to Norman right there. Just did a good job of hitting the spots.
You know, it's not a high probability pitch to hit. You know,
I mean, sure. You're not going to hit that real hard. If you do, you're going to hit it. You're going to roll it over to the left side somewhere. There's that same pitch as Graves goes.
Gosh, he was out by a mile there.
Yeah, he had a bad jump. Yeah, he had a bad jump there. I was watching Barrow that time just to see, like, how quickly he rolled through his stretch, and he did go to his – he stopped and went, and he didn't hold it.
Yeah.
And a lot of those guys, they try to time that, and just good timing there on Barrow's part. So.
Well, after four, we're still tied 1-1 as we go into the top of the fifth. We'll be back in just a moment. We are back here in the top of the fifth of your Farmers Baseball. Unfortunately, we weren't able to capitalize on runners on the corners that time. 1-1 your score after four. Here at the top of the fifth, number 11, Condell for the Fox is going to lead off.
Colin Berry, 66 pitches through the first four innings. Averaging about 16 and a half pitches an inning. First pitch is fouled to the right side. It's one of those arms you want to get as many pitches, quality pitches out of that you can. You'd like to see a short inning here if at all possible.
He jumps ahead with that pitch that he fouls off to the right side.
Good pitch there. Yeah, Brady. Beat his glove after it kind of popped out of the side of it.
Nice pitch. I bet if he catches that, he probably has a higher chance of getting that call.
I agree. Yeah, you've been behind the plate enough to know it's hard to call those strikes, even when they might be across the plate, but whenever they don't catch it, it just doesn't look good, you know?
Yeah.
Two balls, one strike, count to Condell. Barry gets his sign, steps back and delivers. Inside corner, gets the call.
Great pitch.
Yeah, evens it up 2-2. See if they go back to that same part of the plate here.
Nice pitch.
That one goes back out across the middle. You're right, that was a nice pitch. Fouled off to the right side. It's going to stay 2-2. Barry gets his sign, takes a step, fires home. Nice breaking ball there. First out of this fifth inning. Swing and a miss there by Condell. Brings up Lemon.
Here in the top of the fifth, one out after that strikeout by Barry.
Tie game 1-1 here. Nice first pitch.
There we go. He's so much more successful when he pitches. I mean, look how quick he's getting ready when he gets that first pitch.
Gets into that zone.
Yeah.
Change up there a little high. But, yeah, you're right. He's taking that sign and takes a deep breath, and he rolls.
It's almost like he has a pitch clock.
Yeah, right. We've talked about that, but I'm not going to say I don't like it.
There's things
that I like
about it. 2-hour
and 33-minute games.
I like getting my money's worth at the ballpark. Just like being there, especially the new one when it's got AC, it's 72 degrees.
Yeah, it ain't bad.
Swing well, that miss. Was one of the things that were our that was the Rangers' advantage.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
You go out there and play a doubleheader in that heat when it's 95 in May.
See the last one to melt. Fouled back there, stays 2-2. Now, I remember we took our kids out there when they were younger, and it was about two innings in, and it was time to go.
Mm-hmm. But when you've got teams coming from the north, the Yankees, Expo, you know, those guys coming down, it's a big difference.
For sure.
Great pitch. Second strikeout of the inning.
When you look at what we were able to recruit some pitching this year, that's something we've never been able to know. What pitcher would want to come and pitch in Texas?
Sure.
And, look what's going on out there now.
Number 10, Bowen, left fielder for the Foxes.
I agree.
Two outs after those two quick strikeouts by Barry.
Maybe a little low there.
Yeah.
Exactly. Went with a breaking ball first pitch, goes fastball this time, so mixing it up pretty good. Another fastball there, foul to the right side.
Evens the count, one ball, one strike.
Barry takes a sign, kicks, delivers, called strike. They're on the inside part of that plate. Makes it one ball and two strikes.
Barry way ahead here with two quick strikeouts and getting ahead 1-2 in this count on Bowen. With nobody on here in the top of the fifth.
Well, just got a piece of that breaking ball. Good-looking pitch there on 1-2.
Yeah, he just caught a little bit of it.
Mm-hmm. Definitely caught him off balance.
Still 1-2 on Bowen. As Barry's already set with his sign.
Got him. Strikes out the side for the second time in the game. Oh, there we go, Coop.
There we go. Well, quick three strikeouts for Barry. Still score 1-0 as we come to the bottom of the fifth. We'll be back in just a moment.
We're
back here in the bottom of the fifth after quick three strikeouts from Colin Barry. Leading off for the Farmers is Brady Gray. Takes first pitch outside for ball one.
See how Brady's wrist is feeling after taking that one off of it earlier on that foul tip.
You know, I saw his frustration when Graves got thrown out by 47 feet at second base. You know, flung his bat over there. I mean, this is a big game for us.
Yeah,
you know,
for sure.
I'm not sure if it has been or if it – when it has.
Well, that's deep to center field, but center field had played perfectly.
But the boys were shooting, you know, so we had a crawfish boil last night for the boys because they swept community. Mr. Tony Gray had given them the challenge. You sweep them, we'll do it.
Buy some crawfish.
And they did. They did it at home. And so we did that last night. And the crawfish disappeared.
Pretty quick.
Quicker than we could boil it. And
not a surprise.
So big thanks to Tony and Heather, Blackland Glass, and also Legacy RV Rentals for pitching in to do that for the boys. If I missed anybody else, somebody needs to text me. So we said it again last night. If they sweep district 10-0,
okay,
we're going to have a big crawfish bowl.
Bigger crawfish bowl.
Yeah.
Nice.
He definitely pulled that in and got that strike.
Yeah, he did.
One ball, two strikes on Strawn. As he sets in here with one out. Nobody on in the bottom of the fifth.
Right up the middle.
Number 5, Colin Berry.
Yeah, and, you know, we've seen this a couple of times where Farmersville, they seem to kind of go in this funk all at the same time where it's just, you know, hard to put back-to-back hard-hit balls together, get, you know, multiple base runners in an inning, and then when they've had it, this game, unfortunately, you know, at one point they had the bases loaded with no outs and still weren't able to score, so. See if Colin can help himself out here a little bit. Watches that ball low. Runs it to 2-0. Another outside pitch.
Good try. Cooper.
Yep, Jaren says, good try, Cooper, and he's right. I think some of those guys out there are really kind of pressing a little bit. Team that you're supposed to beat.
Yeah.
At home.
The defense is definitely locked in. I mean, you look at the scoreboard. Pitchers are going back and forth on strikeouts and grounders and pop-ups.
Yeah. Well, the barrel here has not been overpowering by any means. They just haven't been able to barrel one up, really. There you go. Get you your first base runner there.
Well, and I was talking to
makes Barrow throw more pitches too. So
sure. You know, I was talking to Tony Gray actually, and it was how we are with inferior pitching. Mm-hmm. You know, you take the look at what we played last Friday. Aiden Terry throws upper 80s,
mm-hmm.
13 runs off of him.
Right.
In two innings.
Uh oh.
And then Nix, the freshman for community, comes here and throws Tuesday night, considerably less velocity, spins a lot of his pitches, and just, you know, we don't do as good.
Cause some problems for sure.
First pitch to Irwin here in the box for ball one.
86th pitch of the game there for Barrow. Extend this inning a little bit longer. May not see him next inning. Nice
line drive
there.
Back up the middle for Irwin. Great job barreling it up.
That's what we needed. A couple base runners there.
You know, it's crazy. Something like that, you kickstart the guy on deck.
Sure.
You lay down. Well, we've got two outs, but you know, difference. You lay down a bunt right here with the speed, able to move, and that's just how things kind of start. It could snowball
in a hurry,
one way or the other.
Yeah, in a hurry for sure, and we've seen it.
Two outs here, runners in first and second. Brings up Logan Dale. First pitch is outside in the dirt for ball one.
First breaking ball, first pitch we've seen from Barron in a little while.
Yeah, he's usually trying to get that
fastball.
That fastball.
Yeah. Goes back to the outside corner. Nice little throw there from Robinson from his knees. And the thing about a throw like that is, yeah, it didn't get anyone out, but you're just showing them that you can do it. You know, it just gives everybody something else to think of. It's like Brady whenever he's back picking at first or third.
It's in the back of the mind of a runner for sure. Time. Two balls, no strikes.
Outside again.
Well, with Collins' walk, his pitch swinging for the single, and then three balls a row here, obviously it's a definite red light. But,
yep.
You know, and with KJ coming up next on deck, he had him the green light.
Yeah. Yeah. Norton shaking his head like, okay.
He still has to come back with a pitch.
Yeah, he's still got two more. Yep.
Two swings and two strikes on Dale there, back-to-back pitches. Brings a count full.
Full count's two outs.
Two outs.
Runner's going to be running.
On the pitch.
Make a little contact here. Make this defense make a play.
Not going to agree with that call, but that is strike three on Dale.
Looked outside and low to me. So after five full, still tied 1-1.
Left a few runners, a couple runners on there, which is unfortunate. So Barrow's at 93 pitches after five. Barry's going to probably come back in for sure for this inning and see if we can make it quick work.
Yep.
We'll be back in just a moment for the top of the sixth. We are back here in the top of the sixth. Leading off for the Foxes, number two, Colby Porter. I expect to see him Tuesday night in Caddo. Colin Barry's still on the bump, starting the inning with 83 pitches. As we were just talking, Barrow's at 93 through five. First pitch swing in there for Porter, able to poke it through shortstop over there. Dive in effort by Dale.
And the person who did it is like a senior. They're going to change people.
Well, does set up the double play, which we've turned one tonight, turned a couple the other night. Barry goes to first. Just let Porter know that knows that he's over there. Shows bump, pulls it back. A little inside on that first pitch.
One ball on McIntosh. Porter at first for the Foxes. Barry comes set.
Oh, wow.
Oh, he's calling that fair.
Yeah, it was. It was fair.
It was? I thought it might have caught him in the box.
No. Now, that part I didn't see. I know it stayed fair, but that's about the hardest swinging bunt you're going to see. So Looks like Porter stretching a little extra after he came around second base. So no outs here as Barrow steps up to the plate. Two runners on. So the bags are hot. Get a chance to tag one. Go to the next. Good pitch. Yeah, Barrow steps out and has a little word with himself or possibly the umpire.
Nice pitch. It was a nice pitch to get ahead there, 0-1. Runners on first and second here in top of the sixth. No outs.
That's so gross. Why would you think of like that?
Shows bunt. Tries to put it down. Fouls it back, though. It's going to make it 0-2. Might take the bunt out of the options here. Two pitch on the way. Slow roller to the left side. Nice play there by Johnson. Able to get the runner going to second. Graves holds on to it smartly. Doesn't force it to one of the bags.
Yeah, and still leaves a double play for this batter. Those runners on the corners.
And that and Porter going to third. Kind of took a big, you know, kind of rounded that a little bit. And so Paxson's keeping an eye on him in case he went a little too far off base. So Brady's going to go out and talk to his pitcher here and then also probably signal to his infield what they're going to do if they do attempt to go from first to second.
I don't see anybody in the bullpen.
No, I don't see anybody up. I think this is more about what they're going to do.
Situation.
Defensively, yeah, if there's a bunt or if somebody does try to take second.
You know, while we've got – little break here. I know the umpire's kind of moving them on, but you know, a game like this brings a different intensity to the game. I mean, it's 1-1.
Mm-hmm.
You know, records to me don't matter.
Sure.
Because you know, you look at the bigs. They've got. I mean, you get to these championship series and they split them 3-2. I mean, you know, one game is 10-0. One game is 2-1.
Yeah.
I mean, so.
It's just all about trying to get the win, whatever, however, and whatever that looks like. First pitch fouled off to the right side.
Screen brings it back in to almost to the foul line.
No balls and a strike to Douglas. One out, runners on the corners.
Showing a bunt early.
Yeah, he's just going to try to see what the defense is going to do, which they didn't tip their hand at all.
Dad.
Yeah.
That's twice he's done that. It's going to have to be a.
Yeah, Barry was taking a little extra time there.
I was wondering if he was going to. It's just I hate it when they're already in the motion.
Yeah, I agree.
And obviously, you know, he doesn't hear it as well as a batter. But
well, and, I mean, Collins sat there for a long time holding that ball. I like it whenever he gets a chance to restart too. So ground ball goes to third. Johnson to second. Didn't – they're going to say that – did he come in a little high on that one?
I was almost expecting – because he was in and he caught that ball on the grass, I was almost expecting him to come like, home with it.
Yeah,
Brady was
yep.
ready for it at home.
Yeah.
And then leave those runners at first and second.
Let's go.
Like I said, I'm not sure what was discussed.
Yeah. Runner scores on the fielder's choice there. Gives the Foxes a 2-1 lead here. Two outs, runner on third. Robinson at the plate. Good pitch. Painting that corner again. There he looks the runner back.
Yes, I did.
1-1 pitch outside makes it 2-1.
Exactly. I heard that. Oh my God. Stop it. Don't do that.
And again, we talk about the value of base runners, and that's what the Foxes did in this inning. They didn't hit the ball a lot, really hard. They had a couple of little singles, but
easy little flip.
Yep, able to put enough guys on to where nowhere else to put them, and you move them around and able to scratch one out. So,
well, after five and a half, Fox is able to scratch a run out of there from the leadoff single by Porter. Brings the game 2-1 as we come into the bottom of the sixth. We'll be back in just a moment. Back here in the bottom of the sixth.
Playing a little Sweet Caroline here for our friend Kyle Cathy, watching the game at home.
Six, seven, eight due up here in the bottom of the sixth.
Barra still on the mound. He's got about 16 pitches before he hits his limit of 110. Caden Johnson leading off for the Farmers here in this bottom of the sixth. First pitch, curveball outside. Catches a corner there, makes it even 1-1.
Tell her I fixed it.
Again, the Farmers looking for one run here to tie this thing up. A couple to get ahead. Good pitch. That low outside corner, Barra's been able to find that pitch a couple of times tonight. Makes it a ball and two strikes.
Setting up way outside. That's not strike three.
No.
You can't set up outside
and then reach outside for the ball and it still be a strike.
Yeah, not strike three.
No. So the strikeout brings up Malone with an out here in the bottom of the sixth. Barrow closing in on 100 pitches in the game. Got a 110 pitch limit here in the UIL varsity level. Next pitch will be his 100th of the game. Called strike. How's that one away to the right side? If I'm not mistaken, Malone kind of got it started back in the fourth inning when we ended up loading the bases and then not being able to score. But like you said earlier, it's all about just getting on base, whatever that looks like and however you do it.
Yeah, hopefully he can kick something start right here. Two strikes. He's going to be looking to
Yeah, defensive swing there. Couldn't get that ball in the outside corner. So two up, two down here for the Foxes in the bottom of the sixth. Two strikeouts by Barrow. It's going to bring up second baseman Paxson Graves. I do agree with his walk-up music. First pitch swing, he hits out to the right side. Going to land out there in that big foul territory.
That's where he blooped that single last time, just fair. Not sure if he's a little behind. He's usually a pull hitter for the Farmers. A little high and outside. Evens the count. One ball, one strike on Graves. Pop set up to second.
Right fielder.
Shallow right field. After six complete, your Farmers trail the Foxes 2-1 as we come in here in the last inning. We'll be back in just a moment.
First pitch of the seventh inning. It's fouled back. As Barry gets ahead, 0-1. Cantu, the designated hitter, digging in. Good pitch. Hey, you guys just got that same pitch. No need in complaining over there on that Caddo side.
Right. When they set up outside and brought.
Yes. Yeah, don't. Mm-mm. They appealed down to the first base umpire who was looking at his shoes. Good pitch. That's at least seven strikeouts for Colin tonight, and I know that's because he struck out the side twice.
Correct.
But I'm sure there's a few more mixed in there, so. Jaron is right. That was a very nice pitch. Pretty close to his 100th pitch of the night. As Condell digs in. Can't catch up with the first pitch fastball. Barry gets ahead in the count again. Ah, nice.
Great pitch.
Really had Condell out on that front foot there. I know what I'd be yelling if I was in the stands right now. Got to be consistent. Got him in the dirt, Brady. Knocks it down. Throws to first. So two up, two down here in this top of the seventh. Powered by two strikeouts by Colin Berry. That is going to bring up number four, Lemon.
That second strikeout brings up two outs here. A little show bunt. Able to bring it back.
Barely. Just a little inside, but nice place to miss when someone's showing a bunt. Get on those hands. Does try the bunt this time. But fouls it back, makes it two balls and one strike. Here with two outs in the top of the seventh. Fox is up 2-1. Another good pitch there by Colin Berry here, just nibbling on that outside corner.
Two balls, two strikes.
His Lemon looks a little perplexed up there.
Brady's sitting up just on that outside corner.
He's got looking for a high one, too.
Bounces right off that knee guard.
Yeah, it did. Might have been the thigh bone.
I agree. Great pitch. Great pitch.
Strikes out the side for the third time tonight as the Farmers go in the bottom of the seventh looking for one run to keep this game going. 2-1 here.
I'd like to see him, he's going to stay at 108 pitches because he's obviously not coming out, but we need to go in there and get two runs.
Yep.
Bats have kind of been.
Been flat.
Yeah, I've been flat this game. I mean, you can tell it's been a defensive game. Pitchers have come out here and done great. They both respectively thrown over 100 pitches each.
Yep.
So you're going to see Colby Porter come in for the Foxes as Barrow shifts to short to close out the game. So we'll be back in just a moment.
Just a small town girl.
Now pitching for the Foxes.
Back here in the bottom of the seventh for your Farmers baseball. Last chance for your Farmers as they trail the Foxes 2-1 after a couple little single spots put up by the Foxes. Leading off here in the bottom of the seventh, number two, Caden Norman. Pitching change for the Foxes. Brings in shortstop Colby Porter and moves pitcher Barrow to shortstop. First pitch misses outside there for ball one.
Yeah, could have found Barrow just looking for the blue glove.
Yeah. You know, you can have all a color glove. You cannot have a white pitching glove.
So curveball for a strike there. And you and I were talking in between innings watching him warm up. He didn't throw a fastball for a strike, even during the warm-ups there. So he still hadn't thrown one for a strike.
That one misses up and away.
So as a hitter, you know, if you're paying attention and you see these things and you know that he's struggling and he's got to throw a strike, then you got to know what kind of pitch to be looking for.
You know, in the way, you know, he struggled, I think he only pitched two innings the other night against Sunnyvale in that loss, 36-38 pitches.
Mm-hmm.
So
he's also a little frustrated, you would think, coming out there and trying to make some amends. Maybe overthrowing a little. Nice job there, Norman, fighting that one off.
Two balls, two strikes on Norman as he pokes that one foul.
I see her. Is that her?
Remains 2-2. No outs.
I'm going to call curveball here because he's got a good one. Yep.
Norman is able to.
Fights it off there.
Yes, I'm going to go in your car.
Poke it off there.
Yep.
I'm going to make sure I go to the back.
Wouldn't be surprised to see him go with that same pitch again.
It's been his best out of
yeah, he's thrown it well.
Six he's nine. Thrown.
Fastball. Job by Norman. Keeping the at-bat alive.
Yeah, it's a seven-pitch at-bat.
Yep.
Not that you're really worried about pitch count.
Yeah, right.
At the bottom of the seventh on a new pitcher. But if the frustration can get to him mentally.
Sure, fatigue could set in. Another one.
Straight back.
Yep.
Stay with it here, Norman.
Two-two pitch on the way to Norman. High.
Brace count full. That was that fastball.
That was, yeah. He's throwing a lot of high fastballs. Norman digs in, gets comfortable. High curveball. Again, he goes back to that pitch when he has to have it, right? When he has to have that strike, and I really hope that these guys that are on deck are kind of watching that and picking up on that trend because that could make a huge difference. Yes, huge difference. So,
leadoff walk there for Norman as he drew a 10-pitch at bat on Porter. With that walk brings up our Nord's going to call time real quick and
yep.
congregate with Cooper, Brady, and Caden. Brady's going to be.
So, you know, these two guys coming up are two of your better power hitters, but they're also just two of your better hitters. So you really do have the ability to play some small ball here. You know, you can look for a gap and use Norman's speed. So a lot of options here.
Brady Gray's going to follow up Norman after that walk. Due up next for the Farmers.
We'll see how close that Caddo coach decides to play these corner infielders.
Just a big barrel right here, like you were talking about.
Just find a gap.
You know, he can He can put it anywhere in this park. We just need something hard somewhere.
You know Norman can run.
Porter's taking a little bit longer.
So, again, another ball on the fastball. As he and the catcher seem to maybe have got their signals crossed up as they're both kind of looking at each other like.
A little miscommunication.
Yeah.
Regardless, first pitch ball misses just outside for Gray.
You know, and he does not release the ball as quickly as Barrow does, so you got to think that the steal could be on at some point. There's that curveball.
I will say that's his best pitch. He's thrown it for a strike.
Has
more
been
times
tonight.
Than not.
Yeah, has been tonight. He goes to it whenever he's needing to get that strike.
Well, that strike evens the count. One ball, one strike on Gray.
But you don't want to hang one of those curveballs to these two guys. This
no.
Brady or Coop behind him. Outside. So two balls and a strike. Really interested in what he decides to throw here. Goes back to the well on that curveball or not. Nope. Can't throw that. He's just having a hard time placing that fastball.
Low one in the dirt.
Yeah. And he's worried about the runner, too, because.
He is. Robinson's going to take a little minute to talk to him. And
that was almost a slide step there, which is the first time that he's done that tonight. And so that tells you that he's really trying to get rid of the ball as quick as possible because he's speed on first base. But what that does is just throws your whole rhythm out as a pitcher up there.
You know,
when you're having a hard time locating a fastball, it's the last thing you want to do is throw your own rhythm out. So.
Three balls, one strike.
As
Porter comes set after talking with Robinson.
Yep.
Another walk, misses outside.
Another fastball outside of the zone.
Number 10, Cooper Strong.
Caddo's coach going to take a moment to come out and talk to his pitcher and catcher.
And I understand the frustration for Porter. I mean, he's thinking he needs to get that high strike, but that, I was talking about this earlier, the umpire has been consistent. He will give him a corner, but he's not giving that high strike. He's giving him the lower part of that zone. And so whenever you, when you react like that, it looks like you're almost kind of begging, right? Now you're putting more pressure on yourself.
Sure, you know, and the pause look at the, yeah, at the umpire,
yep,
never really goes in your favor.
It doesn't help. No.
That zone tends to tighten. But no outs. Runners on first and second. Brings up number 10, Cooper Strawn. Definitely has the ability to do some damage here. Brady's going to be your winning run. Tying run is on second with Norman.
Yeah, Norton's giving Norman a little extra coaching there, letting him know where his outfielders are. That's what we needed right there.
That ball in the dirt moves the runners up bags. We've got,
you've got your game-winning run in scoring position with no outs right here. And your best hitter on, and I guarantee they're about to walk him. Yeah, they're going to walk Cooper is my guess and load these bases, and that's exactly what they're going to do. Yeah. Which,
hey, it's smart because they have no force right now.
There's, yeah. That's the easiest decision that coach has made.
And if Colin Berry's ever been due for a hit,
it's now.
You know, tonight.
Help himself.
He's pitched great on the mound.
Completely agree.
So, what an opportunity for him.
So, and if you, we can't go back and watch it, but so Norman took a big, like a jab step off of second before that pitch, and Porter was looking at him as he was coming home, and again, just throws him way out of rhythm and holds on to that ball too long, throws it in the dirt. Farmers are in position now.
Porter able to get that low pitch in there for a strike against Barry.
It's only the second fastball he's thrown for a strike this inning, so I don't blame Colin for getting up there and taking a close one. Now you got to be ready for that curveball.
I agree.
Then Jaron agrees. Fastball in the outside corner.
Outside.
He misses, yeah.
He's missed every time there.
Yep. They're high.
That pitch evens the count. One ball, one strike here in the bottom of the seventh.
I agree.
Bases are loaded.
Huh?
Two balls, one strike.
Yeah. So Porter is kind of tensing up a little bit on the mound out there. You can see that he's really trying to aim this thing instead of throwing it, and that's a really hard thing to do as a pitcher.
That's what we were talking about with Colin earlier when he was struggling. You were frustrated and took the hat off. You know,
right.
He was trying to, you know, get those pitches. You know, had a couple four-pitch walk and got to a 3-0 count.
And it just makes it harder on yourself as a pitcher out there.
Big swing there.
Sure, I like that.
Evens account 2-2. I mean, it was just under the numbers.
Yep. Well, Colin was kind of stepping out when he swung there too, so he was, you know, taking an extra big hack there. I want to shorten this up just a little bit. Contact is your friend right here. Just like that, right there.
That's going to be
That's going to be it.
That's going to be through.
Freddie Gray comes around third.
It's going to
be a play at home, and he is safe. There we go.
Walk off Colin Berry. Gets the win and the walk-off.
And they're going to try to run him down in center field. They're going to have to head him off, though. So the Farmers come back tonight and win in the bottom of the seventh on a 2-RBI single by Colin Berry that gives himself the win on the mound. So really proud of those guys coming back. You and I talked about before the inning started, Nelson, that they're having a hard time piecing together those hits at the right time and hitting, barreling the ball up. Well, you put some base runners on and a couple of walks, pass ball moves them over, and then just great situational hitting right there by Colin Berry. Picks up the victory for the Farmers and keeps them undefeated in district.
Great job. You know, I probably got a little loud there on the live stream. I apologize to you guys in the house. But, man, being a small ball baseball guy, you know,
love it.
Putting the ball in play, he went oppo.
Yep.
And, you know,
you and I were talking about when he misses with a fastball, he's missing on the outside
he's
part of the plate.
The outside,
right?
So
and that's exactly where he hit it.
And
so
what Colin did is he took that – he didn't want to take a chance of that ball being strike three on the
right
corner. He took that pitch to the outside, poked it through. Brady was going from the get-go. Norton was waving them around. Just a great way to finish.
Absolutely.
I know that we're better than 3-2, but –
but we got a W.
I need to put those runs up on the board real quick. Let me get
it. There, it's on there right now. Yeah. Well, for those of you that join us at home, we when is the next home game? It's going to be next Friday.
We play at Community. Both the varsity girls and the varsity boys play Tuesday in Community. I mean, excuse me, in Caddo.
Okay.
For a back-to-back game again.
Yep. So, home and home.
Yeah, and then we should be home
next Friday.
Next Friday. So
right,
thank you guys for joining. You picked a good one.
Absolutely.
Enjoy your Good Friday for those of you off. Enjoy
yes
your Easter weekend.
Hope you all have a great Easter weekend.
And thank you for supporting Farmers Baseball.
As always, go Farmers.
Camel?